Okay, so this is another quick overview of how to find what is due and to submit the correct assignments. Especially in language arts, you are going to have to do every part of every printable and every page because it might be something you submit later. So a good example of this is that for this 01.04, I'm getting a lot of incorrect submissions. When you go into the content, you have to click through page by page and complete every part of the reading and the prompting. Now, if you're doing something like cursive, it might be that you practice a few X's and a few Y's and a few Z's and then move on. But if it's asking you to complete something within your graphic or with like a graphic organizer within your interactive journal, that might very well be what you submit. So this is where the assignment begins, is in page 4 of 10 of this content. If you're jumping straight to the submission, you're not going to know what to do. So it goes over what you do when you compare things. You need to click on all of these different tabs and go through the lesson. So for instance, it's going through things that you've already done and things that it has started to dive into in previous lessons. That's why you have to start at the very beginning and move all the way through. So here's where the actual assignment comes into play. And if you're jumping to the very end, you might not know. It says the mystery of the missing light. And it says, as you read the mystery of the missing light, use what you know about asking and answering questions to understand the story. You get the story here, right? So you're able to click through the interactive and read it. Okay. Then this is a practice version, right? Where you create a compare and contrast graphic organizer in your interactive notebook. Use details from the story for these elements: the cottage and lighthouse, Carolina and the lighthouse keeper, the problem and the event. Okay. So you are looking at the similarities and differences, and you create your own version of that. Now it's going into the writer's workshop, and here's another practice page where, again, you might do all the evens of this practice page. But when you get to this one, this is where you are submitting the compare and contrast graphic organizer for the mystery of the missing light that you developed on page 5. So if you skip that and don't go through every page, you're not going to understand what to submit. So you're actually making your own organizer that looks like this, and you're adding the details from the questions that they ask you to do right into your interactive journal. And that interactive journal is just a notebook, right? It's whatever paper you have around that you can go into. But like, even if you look at math, if you're jumping straight to the assignment submission, you aren't going to understand which pages are printables and which pages are things to be submitted. So when we look at week 4, yes, you have quizzes here, but you've also got practice pages within that if you aren't pausing to do at least part of these practice pages, when you get to the quiz, you aren't going to be doing very well because you haven't worked through this content and curriculum. So I'm seeing low quiz scores and incorrect submissions because you guys aren't taking the time to go through all of the content. And when you do get to a page where there's actually an assignment that has to be uploaded, you are going to find the printable or the directions for how to do that embedded within. So this summarizes all of the practice that you did, and then it's going to give you the page that you have to print or do. Again, I don't mind if you handwrite this into a journal, but please don't type the answers straight in, right? Because then I don't know if you just didn't get a calculator, type this in, and boom, get the answer. So I need to see it in your interactive journal where I actually get to see your work. Even if you don't print this, I need to see that you've written it out and then you scan and upload that or take a picture of it where I can see your work. So I'm just reiterating, this is how you're going to get credit for assignments. You're going to slow down to go through all the content. You're going to find exactly what the content is telling you to submit by going through each lesson page. You're going to do half of all practice pages, and then you are going to either print or fully complete and submit the final thing that is due in each class. And again, your quiz scores are going to go up if you slow down to make sure that you're engaging with the content rather than jumping right to the quiz. So I know we're all getting used to this, but I want to make sure that you're set up for success to do well.